Shop my stash. It's time for me to switch out my products. Haven't done one of these in quite a while, maybe about a month and a half, I think, but I'm ready to pick some new stuff. So I'm just going to run quickly through some of the items that I haven't spoken about before, maybe that I'm going to put back, and then we'll pick some new stuff. So I'm just going directly out of my drawers today. So let's start with the foundation. So this Zoeva foundation here, nice coverage, very nice natural type finish. I actually really like this foundation. It is a hint lighter than I would like, you know, for my foundation shade to be. I can definitely work with this because, you know, with bronzer, powder, and all that stuff, I've learned how to kind of maneuver with shades that are a little off. So it's actually a really nice foundation. I enjoyed using this, but because it's just a hint lighter than I want, it's probably not something I would reach for on a regular basis. But the coverage is nice and the finish is nice. Nice natural finish. This is definitely one of my new favorites as far as like affordable foundations. This Catrice, what is it, True Skin Hydrating Foundation. I love this stuff, you guys. It's really nice. And this color works very well for me. It's warm spices. And I really, really enjoyed this. I would definitely reach for this over and over again. Very nice foundation. This Pretty Fresh from ColourPop. I'm actually going to just leave this in my drawer. I kind of keep it in my drawer whenever I want a nice, easy, beautiful, kind of lightweight coverage, you know, situation. I just grab this. So I always keep this in my drawer. For concealers, this one here, this Uma Beauty Woke. This is one that I pulled to use. And I've been using it quite a bit and I actually really like it. I didn't think I was really going to like the finish of this, but it's actually pretty nice. It's a really good concealer. Nice coverage, blends out very easily, but it doesn't blend away. So I actually really like this. So yeah, really good. I have my usuals that I keep in here all the time. You know, my Juvias number 11, that's not coming out. And my Essence Camouflage. I use this for my dark circles. That's not coming out, but I will switch out my other concealer. So let's move into like serums and moisturizers and primers and stuff. So I've been using this Glow Recipe Watermelon Glow Pink Juice for a moisturizer. Really like this, very lightweight, kind of like water-based moisturizer, but it really does make my skin feel nice and supple and soft prior to my makeup application. So that has been really nice. I use this Fourth Ray Beauty Thirst Aid Hydrating, what is it, priming moisturizer for the first time. And I've used it quite a bit. Actually, I'm almost halfway through this since I pulled it. I like this. This is a very, very nice moisturizer. I mean, I don't really quite understand priming moisturizers that much when they feel like just regular moisturizers, because, you know, that's what it feels like to me. This is a really good one, though, if you're looking for a priming moisturizer. This one, you know, I got from ColourPop. Very, very nice. This Huda Beauty, this is their water jelly primer, I believe. Yeah, water jelly primer. Another nice, lightweight, just kind of hydrating, plumping. Well, I shouldn't say plumping, but, you know, it makes my skin feel nice and supple when I use it. So I like this. Water jellies are not my favorite type of primer, but it is a good primer just for a quick hydration underneath your makeup. Also, I tried out this LYS Secure Skin Gripping Serum Primer. Once again, nice primer. If you like kind of that just slightly tacky feel in a primer, and it does have kind of like that serum type vibe to it, then you might like this. So, yeah, I think I got this. Did I get this in my boxy? I think I might have got this in my boxy, and it's actually a product that I'm glad I got. Works really well. This I showed in a recent video, and this is my Beauty Bakery Butter. What is it called? Antioxidant Hydra Silk Primer. So, yeah, like I said, I had avoided this primer for quite a while because I felt like it was going to be like super silky and slick and all of that, but it actually dries down kind of like matte, you know, blurring and matte when you use it. So it's really cute, easy to use, and I definitely will pull for this. I can put this on correctly. I definitely will pull for this. Very cute packaging as well in the future for sure. Actually, no, I'm going to put that back. I was thinking about keeping it for a while, but I'm going to put that back. Powders. So this box here, this is my little powder box that I always use in here. It's just an easier way for me to use powder because it's bigger and easier for me to get to. So I keep some of my DJ's Unique Boutique powder in there. But the powder that I've been using a lot since I pulled it is this Prime Beauty Loose Setting Powder. I love this stuff, y'all. Love it, love it, love it. I cannot sing its praises enough. I like the fact that it's not too heavy. The color is perfect for setting under my eyes. It's just beautiful. I love it, but I'm gonna go ahead and pull something else. Y'all know, I know y'all sick of me talking about this KVD Powder Foundation. This is the Lock It in Deep 200. Yo. I love this stuff so much, I actually purchased 2 refills because they were selling refills, I think, on Sephora. They had them on sale. Girl, I picked up 2 refills for this, okay? So I'm so glad I have refills for this because this is like the perfect powder foundation, setting powder, all of that for me. It just works great. So love this. Gonna give it a rest though. Okay, so I'm gonna move over to this other drawer and we'll finish just running through these products. Okay, I've moved over to this other drawer, which has like my blushes, highlighters, bronzers, and stuff like that. Also, I keep in this little container here like my mascaras, my eyeshadow primer, you know, things of that sort, which pretty much I don't switch out very often. You know, my eyeliners I use, my P. Louise base. For let me just take a look at this though. This mascara, this ColourPop Level Up mascara, I actually really have been enjoying. I have been enjoying this. I like the shape of the wand. The shape of the wand, very, very nice. You know, it slenders down at the tip. It's like, it's not too watery, not too thick. It's just, I like it a lot. I really do. I like this whole slender situation. It's not super duper fat like when you get other mascaras, like my other favorite, which is my Thrive Cosmetics. Love this stuff as well. But, you know, holding the packaging, it's a lot thicker. So I'm really enjoying this ColourPop Level Up mascara. Not going to switch that out because I like it a lot. Let's jump into blushes since they're right here on top. So this Rouge Romance from Jaclyn Cosmetics, have been using this quite a bit. Very beautiful shades in here. You can use them all year round. Just beautiful pigmentation, nice staying power, blends out very beautifully with your other powder, you know, makeup. I really enjoy this. I would definitely say this is a very, very nice blush palette, okay? Very nice. This one I actually pulled and I didn't even use it, but I've used it in the past. This is my Sephora Pro, and this one is the Deep. So this one is the Deep Face Palette. I might actually keep this in my drawer, but I already know this is an amazing palette. Just for whatever reason, I didn't really reach for this, but as you can see, it has your blush, your highlighters, your bronzer, all of that good stuff. So, so beautiful, and it's beautiful all year round as well. I think I'm going to go ahead and leave this in my drawer because I do want to use that. Now, this highlighter, I got blue eyeshadow on there. This highlighter, oh my goodness, this was a Holiday Fable Divine Glow Enigmatic Bronze. And this one is from, what did, I always forget the name. It has the, you know, the K's on the front. Kiko Cosmetics. Kiko Cosmetics. I bought this just kind of on a whim around the holidays. It was on sale on Ulta. I was like, you know what? It's gorgeous. Because look at that, honey. It is gorgeous. This has quickly become one of my absolute favorite highlighters. It's beautiful. It's just no getting around it. It is beautiful. It's not too blinding. It blends in with your skin and just makes it look like you are glowing from within, honey. I don't know if this is still available, but if it is, definitely grab it. It is brown girl, black girl, every girl friendly. I love it. It's gorgeous. So this is actually staying in my drawer. This I got from Shop Miss A. It's one of the AOA. This is actually a blush, but for me, it's a highlighter. Absolutely gorgeous. I probably swatched it before, like when I pulled it, but it's more like a peachy toned, you know, highlighter. Very, very pretty, beautiful glaze on the skin. I mean, for a buck, you can't beat it. So I really, really like this. Gonna put it back though. This Revolution Pro Blush and Glow. This one is the Cranberry Glow. As you can see, I've used it quite a bit. And I get a lot of good use out of this whenever I do pull it because it's just absolutely gorgeous. If you like kind of like a beautiful glowy toned blush, it's absolutely gorgeous. And then I like to use this, you know, as a highlighter. Hopefully you can see that. I'm all over the place right now. But, oh, it's so gorgeous. Once again, Revolution Pro, affordable, beautiful. That's actually staying in my drawer as well. Let me clean my hands off. Okay, next we have this Soul. Is it Soul Body? I always forget. Touch and Soul. This is their Glowdient palette. It really is just like a radiant of different like highlighter shades. So, so pretty. Absolutely gorgeous. Love this as well. It's going back. I was surprised by this Huda Beauty Glowish blush. I don't know why. First of all, I was surprised by the size because this thing is tiny. It might not look that tiny to you, but this mug is tiny. Okay, this, let me just show you. Like, this is my minted bronzer, which, you know, is a regular size, little compact, not even that big. But this is the Huda Beauty blush. So, as you can see, it is smaller. So it is quite the little baby blush. I have the shade Berry Juicy, and I use this a few times. Very pretty, looks gorgeous on the skin, nicely pigmented. It's one that I do build up, you know, it doesn't just have that super punch of color when you put it on your brush and apply it. So it is one that is easy to nicely build up. You don't have to worry about just too much blush right off the bat. So I do like that, but it is a beautiful, beautiful shade. I do really like that. So that's going back. Let's go ahead and talk about the bronzers now. I did pull my minted bronzer in Yacht Life. One of my absolute favorite bronzers. The shade is just beautiful. Blends out easily, nicely. Black owned brand. I really, really like this bronzer. It never lets me down. Easy to blend into your makeup. So yeah, this is very, very nice, you guys. Now this vanity makeup, I bought this when I bought the palette. I just used their palette and I totally dropped the ball on trying this out in my video because I did a full face look. But I did not use this face palette that I purchased when I got the eyeshadow palette. So as you can see here, it's cream products. There's a cream bronzer, like concealer, as well as highlight. I don't know what it is about cream products. I'm just not drawn to them. Even though they look beautiful when I use them, I'm not drawn to them. So I think for now I'm going to put this back because it's just taking up room in my drawer. And 9 times out of 10, I'm not going to use that right now. I'll try it one day, just not now. I also pulled my Gucci bronzer. Amazing bronzer. Okay, we all love the beautiful Gucci packaging. But this bronzer is beautiful and amazing as well. Very, very nice. It's just easy to use. And I appreciate that because of the price. You know, I appreciate that. Very, very nice. Nice shade for my skin tone. Blends nicely. And, you know, I've used this before, so you guys know. Very, very nice bronzer. Just makes you feel bougie when you're using it. I have these other two cream bronzers from e.l.f. in here that I haven't used as well. As you can see, it's two different shades. One that's super dark and one that is really the shade I should use for bronzing. Once again, cream products, cream bronzers that I have not used. And it's only because I don't reach for cream products. This one is Sunkissed. So this is the one I would most likely use. I'm going to keep that in my drawer. This darker one is called Beach Please. Very, very deep. I actually was thinking about using this with a brush as a dark brown lip liner, but I kind of feel like it's a little too creamy. It probably would work for that, but I think it might be a little too creamy. So, yeah, I don't know, but I'm gonna leave this in my drawer too, just in case. So that's basically just the main items that I wanted to kind of run through with you guys. Let's go ahead and take a look at the palettes that I used. Okay, so let's quickly run through the palettes that I've used. I think since my last Shop My Stash hasn't been that many because I haven't been doing that much eyeshadow, quite honestly, or I've used palettes, you know, repeatedly. So this Anastasia Beverly Hills, this is the Primrose palette. I did use this very recently, y'all. This palette is so pretty. Every time I open it, I'm just like, oh my gosh, it's so gorgeous. So yeah, I did use this palette. I'm gonna go ahead and insert the look. If I have a picture of it, I'm sure I do because I just used it. But beautiful, warm, kind of earthy, just like, I don't know, date night, everyday, sexy. That's what I get from this palette. Very sexy. The blushes worked. Well, this one here. I didn't use the light one, of course. But the blush worked very nicely for me. It looked beautiful on my skin tone. All the other shades just nicely pigmented. Shimmers are gorgeous. So beautiful, beautiful palette. I do have in here some of my singles from DJ's Unique Boutique. Okay. So these are some singles that I did play around with. I have in here like her white, super white, bright, shimmery single, this silver, this green, and this gold. I do like to use these for like inner corner pops, just pops of color, beautiful lid shades. So these are just some that I pulled out of my DJ's Unique Boutique collection to use, and I have been using those. So super, super gorgeous. Her, I do have a affiliated discount code in my description box if you want to check out her boutique and see what she has. She always has new releases. She has all kind of goodies for you to choose from. Definitely check her out. Okay, and she is one of my besties. This vanity makeup, look at this. Try not to get the lights in there. But this packaging, y'all, is so pretty. So, so pretty. I need to clean it. It's full of fingerprints. But this is their signature palette. I just used this recently. Look at this, y'all. This palette is gorgeous. It is. It is. For a neutral, just basic, you know, everyday palette, it's beautiful. It's pretty pricey, I will say that. But this palette is so gorgeous. Definitely check out my video using this if you're curious about it or if you haven't seen it. Check it out. I really, really enjoyed using this. Excellent quality eyeshadows, okay? Next, these two palettes I did use together. So this MAC, this was, I think, was this part of their holiday collection? It's the Feast Your Eyes palette from MAC. I don't really purchase MAC shadows, so this one, when I saw it, I thought it was so gorgeous. I wanted to, you know, check it out, try it out, and it's okay. It's okay. I will not say it's like my favorite palette or it's the most amazing shadows or anything like that. It's just, it's okay. You know, I have way better shimmers, way better mattes, but it's not a bad quality at all. It's a beautiful palette. It's okay. I combined that palette with my Disney Hocus Pocus palette from ColourPop. So that's what that looks like. And these, oh, I can't talk today. These are the colors in this palette. So you can kind of see why I, I'm sorry, you guys. I'm still coughing like crazy after my COVID. But these are the two palettes together. So you can see why it is that I kind of wanted to play with them, you know, as a unit. They just go super duper well together. They combine well together, and it was so easy for me to create a look using these two palettes. They are beautiful companion palettes. Gorgeous. Next here, I have this palette from XX Revolution. It's the Midnight Luxe. It was so long ago when I used this palette. I believe I used it in a video, y'all. I'm not sure, but I did use this palette to create, I believe, like a smoky type look because I was kind of in the mood for like a gray tone smoky look. So this is the palette that I used. If I could find the picture, I'll go ahead and insert it. Very nice quality. Very nice quality. Revolution is very hit or miss, but with this Revolution, is this the Pro? No, XX Revolution, I don't know, but this palette is quite nice, so enjoyed using it. I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's a nice like velvet texture with the XX on there, and this one is the Midnight Luxe, so yeah, I enjoyed that palette quite a bit. One of my more recent palettes that I've gotten, this one was given to me from Nomad Cosmetics, sent this to me so I could try it out and create looks for you guys. This one is actually going to stay in my palette selection for the upcoming month as well. This is their newest palette, which is the Whistler Snow Lodge palette from Nomad Cosmetics. Look at the packaging, y'all. So cute. But look at the palette. Hello. This palette is gorgeous. And so, you know, I'll insert the look that I created using this. So pretty, you guys. I think with them, their shadows and color stories are just getting better and better, and I love it. It's so pretty. Oh, it's gorgeous. I can't wait to play with this some more. Very nice palette. And then lastly, I did use my Blend Bunny Cosmetics palette. It was quite a while ago, so I will try to dig up the look that I did. This one is the Surge. So this one is the Surge palette. And yo, look at that. This palette is so bomb, honestly. I really need to play with this some more. It has the beautiful bright neon type shades, the deep, deep, super smoky shades, beautiful shimmers in there. This palette is gorgeous, and I really enjoyed using it. It's my first Blend Bunny palette, and I'm so glad that I tried it out. Okay, you guys, so I'm just gonna put these back and then we will go ahead and pull some more items. Okay, so I put these palettes back in this little rack so I can move them out the way. Let's go ahead and pick some new items. Okay, you guys, so over here, I just have a few items that I already know that I wanted to pull for sure for this next Shop My Stash. So I just put them to the side so that I didn't like double pick items out of my drawers. So let's just start with my foundations for this upcoming week or two. This is a Sicily foundation that my girl DJ gave to me. She didn't really care for it. When I swatched it, I actually really, really was like, oh, I can use that. So this is what, Phyto Tint Eclat? Okay. I'm not familiar with this brand or anything like that, but
I'm going to try this out and see how I like it. So this is 7 Mocha. But yeah, that was a gift from my girl DJ. So I am going to be pulling that. I also pulled my Estee Lauder Double Wear. Just because I want to use this for a little while. I have, what is this, 6W1 Sandalwood. So those are going to be my foundations for this choice. I did pull my Beauty Bakery. This is their setting spray. What is all of this? Sweet Grace Baking Spray. So yeah, I'm going to choose this for my setting spray because I haven't used it yet and I need to try it out. I did pick up, oh, I have one more foundation I forgot about. I wanted to use the stick foundation for a little while. So I grabbed this Huda Beauty, hopefully, come on, focus camera. Huda Beauty stick foundation. This one is Cocoa. Yeah, Cocoa. So we're gonna play with this for a little while. I don't really do stick foundations. I'm just not a stick foundation girl, but I bought it, so I need to use it, right? I just got these in the mail, you guys. I saw ColourPop advertising these like heart-shaped blushes. Y'all know I'm a blush freak. So I did go ahead and break my no-buy even more to purchase a couple of these. I'm not going to take them out because obviously you can see them through the package. But super pretty shades, okay? This one is Baby Cakes. So I'm pulling Baby Cakes, and then this one is, what is it? Forever Yours? Yeah, Forever Yours. That is like one of my favorite types of shades when it comes to blush. Gorgeous. So I have those blushes. I also grabbed some of their cute little lipsticks. Sorry about the glare, you guys. But it's like 3 different kinds. This one here is a glossy lip stain. This one here, you know, they're all red toned, of course. This one is a lip lacquer. I think it came in like a little 3-pack, so that should make it easy. But yeah, this is a lip lacquer. And then lastly, they have a lip cream. So that's what that one looks like. And that's what it's called. So yeah, they're just like 3 different type of red toned lip products. I don't really wear red lipstick that much, but I thought those were super pretty and I wanted to try them. So I did grab this red pencil. I think this is more like, it can be used either for eyeliner or lips from ColourPop. It's one of their cream gel liners. And this one's just a really, really pretty red one. And let's see here. Is there a name on here? Yeah. Cherry Me. I think this came with their, or Cherry Pie. This came with their, like, cherry collection that came out not too long ago. And then I pulled just a super dark brown liner. This is from NYX. This is, like, the super dark brown liner that I use on my lips, you guys. It's just, that's the name of it, if you're curious. I got mine from Ulta. I believe it's actually an eyeliner, but I love to use it for my lips because it's retractable. I hate pencils that I have to sharpen. So, yeah. I love retractable pencils for my lips and my eyes. I also grabbed a couple of other new products from ColourPop. This one is from Pretty Fresh. It is pressed face powder in dark 20. Let me open this. You guys, I don't know about this shade, okay? But let me show you guys. Okay, so this is the shade. I'm feeling good about it. I'm feeling good about it. You know, we'll see. We'll see, but yeah, I'm feeling good about it. I just chose it online, so you know how that goes. But I am going to choose that as one of my powders. And then I also grabbed this Touch and Soul Pretty Peachy. This is one of their shimmering body powders. So I got this, of course, to use as a highlighter, but let me show y'all because this has a gang of color in it. I'm gonna have to swatch it. Hold on. Okay, you guys, so I opened it up, so you see, this is what it looks like. Oh my gosh, it's gorgeous, but it's a lot of color in there, but I'm really not scared anymore because that's what the swatch looks like. Hello. That's gorgeous. That is gorgeous. I'm really, really happy that I didn't shy away because of the color. Because, yo, that's pretty. That's going to look really, really good on the high points of my cheeks. It's like a peachy tone. So, yeah, happy about that. So, I'm definitely pulling this as well. Okay, you guys, let's go ahead and pick our primers. I think I'm going to pick two primers. I kind of want to do like a matte primer and I want to do like a jelly type primer this go around. So last time I really, really wanted to use my Milk makeup. And y'all know I was looking all over the place and I thought I had one, but I didn't. So I did grab one. This is the Milk Hydro Grip Primer because I love this stuff. Okay. And I wanted to use it again. So I'm going to pull this for one of my primers. And then I do want to go ahead and use this. This is a Revolution primer. Lighting is kind of crazy right here. But this is a Revolution Mattify Matte and Fix Primer. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and pull this one and see how I feel about it. Because I really don't even remember if I used this or not. I'm thinking I didn't, so let's pull this. Okay, so moisturizer. I think I want to pull like a nice affordable, well, I don't know. I want to pull something I haven't used in a while, but that I know that I really, really love. I absolutely love my Mamad Rose Water. You guys know that. This e.l.f. This is the Super Hydrate. Very nice. I think we're going to do the Neutrogena because I haven't done my Neutrogena Hydro Boost in quite a while. This is a water gel moisturizer. Absolutely amazing for adding just a boost of hydration. I really like that kind of nice supple feeling when I do my moisturizer. Sometimes I like the creamy ones, but this kind is really nice as well. So we're going to go with this for this Shop My Stash. I don't feel like I necessarily need to pull a serum. Not pulling any oils right now. But I do kind of like to have one just in case. You know, on those days when I just want to add a little bit more. So this VDL, this I was talking about not too long ago. This is a, it's like a luminizing primer fresh. Very, very nice when you want to add a little bit of glowiness to your skin underneath your makeup. And it feels great. So I think I'm actually going to pull this so I can use this whenever I feel like having a little bit of glowiness under my foundation. Okay, you guys. So for concealer, you might notice I did like a serious declutter for my concealers. And so, you know, it's a little bit more manageable, quite honestly, in my opinion, for me. And I'll probably do another declutter pretty soon. But this Huda Beauty, I haven't tried this yet. I believe I got this in my BoxyCharm and I just kind of threw it in my drawer because I wasn't ready to use it yet. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and try this concealer out from Huda Beauty, see how I feel about it. What shade is this? See if I can get in this lighting proper. Ooh, peanut butter. Okay. So yeah, we're going to go ahead and try this. It might be a little light, but we're going to try it. And then I also wanted to pull my lip bar. This is their Quick Conceal. I have used this before. I can't really say it's one of my favorites. But I do kind of want to use this up, so I'm going to use it. If I don't really care for it, I'm going to go ahead and switch it out, but I'll go ahead and grab this. This one is Cinnamon in the shade 4. Okay, guys, I know I already have that highlighter from ColourPop. Well, that body shimmer that I'm going to use from ColourPop, which is still on my arm. But I do want to pull at least one more because, you know, I get kind of finicky. And I bought this Pat McGrath and have not even used it yet. Okay, absolutely gorgeous. Let me open it and show you. So this is what she looks like. So pretty. It's like you don't even want to use it, but child, as much as I pay for this, I'm going to use it. Okay, so I'm going to pull this, see how I like it, because some things are beautiful by sight, but when you use them, they're not so great for your skin tone, okay? So I'm gonna check this out and see what's happening. And I think I'm gonna grab one more just because I can't help myself. I kind of want to grab a loose highlighter because I really don't use like my loose highlighters. And they're absolutely gorgeous, but I just really don't use them because they're not the easiest highlighters to work with. You know what I mean? They can get messy. They can get all over the place. They're hard to get out of your drawer. It's just like, chow. But I have some really pretty, like, loose highlighters, like from ColourPop. This is gorgeous. This is one. Was this from Shayla, maybe? I don't know. This is Dewdrop. This one is really, really gorgeous. But, yeah, I don't really use my loose highlighters. And they're so pretty. Which one is... I think this might have been from Shayla. Was this... Pose, yeah, this one is super pretty. Yeah, Shayla times ColourPop, absolutely gorgeous. Y'all, let me see. I think, ooh, and then I have this one from my girl DJ, DJ's Boutique. Hers is Heat Wave, and it's kind of scary because it looks like it's white, but yo, when you see that, you see that? Oh, when you put that on the skin, it is so pretty. So yeah, I'm gonna pull this from DJ's Boutique because it is the bomb, and I want to use that for a loose highlighter. Okay, you guys, so I'm in my bronzer drawer, and I kind of feel like I want to start decluttering some of my bronzers. So I'm thinking I'm going to try out some bronzers that maybe I haven't used in a while, or I haven't even really tried, just so that I can see if I want to keep it or not, or if I want to toss it or not. Like this Milani, this is the Earth Glow pressed powder, but you know, I have this to use as a bronzer because it has more of like, hopefully I can open this, if not, y'all gonna have to bear with me, but it has more of like a red tone to it. Okay, so yeah, for me, it's better suited as a bronzer than a face powder, and it's worked really nice for me in the past, but I'm just not sure now at this point in my makeup stage. So I'm gonna pull this, try it out as a bronzer, and see if I still like it. If not, I'm going to declutter it. Now this here is something that I purchased not too long ago. Absolutely, oh my gosh, it's so pretty. This is, what is it, Deep from Juvias Cosmetics. This is actually a setting powder, but I purchased it because in the store it looked like a beautiful shade for a bronzer, and quite honestly, I don't remember if, all that glare, I don't remember if I tried it out. Looking at the imprint, it doesn't even look like I tried it, so I don't know. But I'm gonna pull this to see if I like it as a bronzer. The shade is just absolutely gorgeous. But yeah, this is supposed to be a pressed powder. I'm going to use it for a bronzer. You guys, I think I'm going to skip past the blush because since I have all of the ColourPop blushes, and then I also kept some blushes from my last Shop My Stash anyway, I really don't feel like I need to pull any more blush for this Shop My Stash. So let's move on. These are face palettes, so I don't really need one of these. I oftentimes don't even go in this drawer unless I'm picking something to travel. So let's skip that and let's move on to powders. So I have the pressed powder that I pulled that I just bought from ColourPop. So I think I'll just pull one more pressed powder for my face. What am I in the mood for? I don't know why it's always hard for me to pull a freaking pressed powder. I really, really don't. This Gucci. I don't even know. Have I tried this? I think I did, and I didn't really care for it. Chow. That's an expensive mistake. What am I in the mood for? I haven't used my J-Cat in a long time, and this was like my favorite back in the day. This is Caramel. Let me take a look at this. Yeah, this was like one of my favorites back in the day. Let me pull this and see if I still like it. Because you know how you get new favorites. That KVD is my new favorite. So let me see if I still like this. Okay, and then I need a quick loose powder. I think I'm gonna just keep this quick and simple. I was looking at my Just Peachy powder, and quite honestly, I feel like I used this in the past, this loose setting powder, and didn't really care for it for under my eyes, but can't remember. But I'm gonna start like clearing stuff out. So this is caramelized peach. I'm gonna try this under my eyes. Seems like it was a little too thick to me. So if I don't like it, I'm gonna declutter it. But yeah, we're gonna try this out for a while. Okay, you guys, so let's quickly run through the palettes that I have chosen to use, or that I want to use. Y'all know how it goes. So I grabbed this Juvia's Place Allure 2 palette. Beautiful. Of course, you guys know Blue Color Story. She is pretty gorgeous. So I pulled her. I don't know, kind of like in a blue mood. So we got the Whale Song palette from Menagerie Cosmetics. Look at the packaging. Pretty, pretty. I can't believe I haven't used this yet. As much as I love blues and greens, man, I was so happy when I was able to get my hands on this palette. So I got it. Definitely gonna use it. What else? Oh my goodness, y'all. I have been picking up this palette, drooling over it for so long. Don't know why I haven't used it yet, because this color story, child, from Sigma. Anyways, this is the Disney Princess Cinderella palette. Has a special place in my heart because Cinderella was my favorite bedtime story, you know, when I was a kid. Favorite Disney story. Maybe it's because I had so many sisters. But yeah, I loved it. So, anyways, this is the color story for this palette. And it's like, it's not anything like super bold and aggressive, but it just looks so amazing to me. I don't know if it's the gold background, but it's beautiful. And I cannot wait to create a look with this. It's so pretty. Okay, I did grab my Kylie palette. I've had this palette for a long time. You guys know it came out quite a while ago, and I did grab it when it came out and just never used it. You guys, know I've been more into like just earthy, neutral eyeshadows lately. This one has a little pizzazz, you know, with the shimmers. It has a black in it, which I really like. So I want to try it out. I've never tried her formula. Don't have any other eyeshadow palettes from her. This is my first one. So, yeah, I'm kind of curious, really, just to see if I like it or not, or if it's like absolutely horrible, because I don't know. So, I pulled that. I pulled these three items to go together. Obviously, this is not a palette. This is actually a like blusher from Beauty Bay in the shade Merlot. And this blush is so gorgeous, but it's so dark. And although I haven't tried it on my face yet, I actually want to use it as an eyeshadow. So I did grab this. I might try it out as a blush as well, but it is so dark, you guys. But I grabbed this beautiful Merlot shade blush to play along with these two Juvia's Place palettes. This one, not that it's really needed, honestly, because the berries has all the depth that I need, quite honestly, down here with this shade. Oh my gosh, it's so gorgeous. And this palette here, which is the blushed rose, I have not used yet. But the colors in here are so beautiful, but it's not quite as deep as I would like for a palette. So I figured, you know what? Let me go ahead and combine these two together and create a beautiful rosy burgundy type, type look. And I don't know, I just pulled this just in case I wanted to play with this as well. So yeah, I know it's strange, but you know, it's like when you have products,
especially one like this. This is like a lot of product that you feel like it might not really work for what you bought it for. You can try and use it for other things. So I'm definitely going to try to use this in an eyeshadow type capacity with these palettes and see what happens. Now this Dose of Colors palette, this is the I Love Sarai Dose of Color palette. Of course I got it on sale because it came out quite a while ago, and I think I got it from, Ulta, because I actually got a defective palette. They put two of the same shades in my palette. One of these shades, I think this one over here, is supposed to be like a really lighter kind of earthy tone tan shade, you know, kind of like a lighter version of this, I believe, but mine is defective and I never returned it, never took it back or anything. So I have this palette that has two black shimmers in it, but I want to kind of combine with this with another palette and just make a beautiful look, because I feel like I haven't even swatched it, as you can see, but I feel, oh Lord Jesus, you know, I'm really not that mad that I got two of these. Look at how pretty that is. You know what? I don't even know if it's coming in clear. Look at that. Oh, that's gorgeous. Ciao. What? Okay, I'm really not that upset that I have two of those in my palette. Yes. Yo. Okay. Yeah, I'm glad I pulled this. So, gonna use that. That's gorgeous. I mean, I'm really not upset because I have plenty of palettes that have like a lighter tone, you know, tan in it. I mean, look at this Kylie palette. Okay. I can use this. I can use this. So it's all good. I pulled the Chocolate Martini palette from Glam Light because out of the liquor collection, you know, whatever it's called, this is the only palette that I did not try. And this color story is gorgeous as well. So I did pull this to use. Look at those shimmers, y'all. Glam Light has some of the most amazing eyeshadows, but this palette is really, really cute. So I did pull that. Okay, I did pull my Lunar Beauty Moonspell Volume 2. Had I been doing makeup like I was supposed to be doing around Valentine's Day, definitely would have used this palette. I mean, it's not a Valentine theme, okay, Moonspell. But the color story can definitely be used to create a beautiful pinky purple toned Valentine look. I mean, look at that. What? Get out of here. You know, it's gorgeous. And I love really deep, rich purple pinky tones. So yeah, I pulled this. Hopefully you guys can see the colors accurately, but it's gorgeous. So I pulled this to use. I also pulled my Clarity Cosmetics Carnival palette. This is one of their pressed pigment palettes. I haven't purchased any of their latest releases. I've seen one or two, I believe, that I haven't grabbed. But this one's super colorful, super beautiful. I just kind of want to play around with this in all its beautiful, colorful glory and just come up with something kind of funky. I also pulled, let me grab them right now. I pulled some of my single shadows. These are from Terra Moon because I ordered some single shadows from them last year. And because it was a pre-order, it took quite a while for them to, you know, be delivered. So I just pulled my whole Terra Moon collection to kind of play with in conjunction with my Carnival palette. So as you can see, Terra Moon, you know, has some of the most beautiful, beautiful shimmers. So these are just shimmers from my whole collection. But the newest ones that I received, I put in here. This is just an empty single shadow palette. I think I got this. Where did I get this from? Who knows? But anyways, these are the newest singles that I got from Terra Moon. Okay. So, so gorgeous. And then the last two palettes I have are this one, which is my Michaela palette from Glam Light. I know, right? Can you believe I haven't even used this yet? It's so pretty. But yeah, I haven't even used it yet. Gorgeous color story. Absolutely beautiful. Not sure if this is still available. Not sure. But it's beautiful. I mean, I never really worry with Glam Light shadows or palettes, anything from them, because they always work amazingly for me. Like I said in my last video, I did order their Hershey Kisses collection that came out, so I'm just waiting for that to come. I don't think that was a pre-order. Was that a pre-order, y'all? I don't know, but I did order it. And then I pulled this Avani Gregg for the Bibs times Morphe palette. I got this quite a while ago, and I've only used it like maybe 2 or 3 times. Doesn't look like I used it at all, quite honestly. But yeah, this is one of the palettes that has like the water activated liners at the bottom, so you can just add water to your liner brush and use any of these shades as a water activated liner. Or you can use it as shadow as well. They're just a little bit more gritty than a normal eyeshadow, but you can still use it. And then it has all these beautiful colors. So I just pulled this just to give myself a little more option, a little more range, freedom, if I want to use any of these shadows in conjunction with my other palettes, okay? Because I haven't really been doing colorful looks lately. So I did, you know, I want to kind of mix it up a bit. Like, girl, get your color vibe back, okay? So yeah, these are all of the palettes. I just kind of switched it from one tray to the other. You see how easy that is? Okay, you have 2 trays, you just move it from one to the other, and then you ain't got to worry about putting it away. So yeah, these are the palettes for my Shop My Stash. These are all my items up here in my little tray for my complexion. Okay, I got everything going on right here. So I'm gonna go ahead, put all this stuff away in my drawer, and I'll see you guys on my next video. Thank you so much for hanging out with me, for checking out my Shop My Stash. If you like this Shop My Stash, definitely check out some of my other ones. Definitely consider subscribing so you can join the KK fam, hang out with your girl. Occasionally I'll pop up with some vlogs, to make a video, stuff like that. But I love just chilling with y'all. So I'm gonna put this stuff away, and I'll see y'all on the next one. Okay. Toodle.